Hi everyone, how are you? God bless you as usual. I'm inviting, as you know. So actually today I have a different illustration that I want to show you, and I believe that somebody is going to be blessed and somebody is going to be encouraged and somebody's life is going to change. God bless you. So the illustration for today is that I want to show you this is what my home is. House, as you can show everywhere. So one thing that I came across, something that I paid attention to it. So look at the front house, the front view of my place. It looks so clean, it looks so smart, it looks so amazing. When somebody enters from the gate, they'll say this place is nice and this place is good, it's smart and everything. So I want to show you the other view, the other side of the house. And this is one of the things that we have to learn as Christians. As you see, okay, before I go, as you see, I showed you this is a clean view, nice view. This is the entrance. And most of us believers, our out view, our front view is so clean. When we present ourselves before people, we look clean. When people look at us, we go to church. The view that we show out there is clean, that they cannot even find any spot from us. But we forget that there are some things that we hide inside us. There are some things that are hidden. In as much as people, when they come to you, we say, God bless you. We use those Christian languages. I'm blessed. I'm highly favored and everything. That's the front view that you portray out there. But guess what? God sees our inner man. He sees beyond what the physical shows like this. He sees beyond. That's your out view. He sees beyond your flesh. He sees what is inside you. Now I want to show you the next view. So as I'm talking, like, these are kind of people we show who we are from the front. When people come to us, we just tell them who we are, what is the good part of us, but we forget the bad part of us. So this is the back of the old place. This is the bucket. Maybe I'll go down a little bit. So this is the bucket. And as you can see, the bucket is in the leaves. There are grasses. It's not well maintained. The whole thing behind, you can see how it is. It's not well organized. And this is how most of us behave, as I said from the beginning. The front view, you saw it. It was clean. When anybody comes in the house, they're like, this house is good, this house is nice. But when you look at the backyard, there are things that were dumped out here. Why? Because it is a hidden place and nobody pays attention to it. Nobody uses this route, so nobody pays attention. Most of the times we are paying attention from the front view. So what am I saying? Many of us, I cannot talk only people about in the world, but even us Christians, you find that, as I said, you find that what you portray before people is the outward view. But guess what? As I said, God searches what is inside. The backyard has deceived who? It's not the whole, because the house cannot just be, the house is not the front only. The house is also the back. That's what makes the house. So what are you hiding behind your house? What is behind your house? Is your house like this? This is a symbol of garbage. These are symbols of sin. The things that we do, that when we present them out there, people, you think, when you present them out there, people will question your Christianity. Are you, if you are living outside church, outside your fellow believers, are you like this? Or are you the front view? If we come in the front view, are we going to find the same view that is in front is what is in behind? So many people, they are hiding their sin, they are hiding their fault. And when you see somebody coming out with their fault, you see their back view, you think that they are not clean. But have you forgotten your own back view? Go out there. If you see that your back view is not what you show in the front view, go and tell God that, God, work on me, work through me, because we are all human beings. We are man in progress. We are all a working process. So if my back view, before I point out somebody's sin, which their back has been exposed, it doesn't mean that you don't have your back. Go out there, work on your back view. Go out there and clean up your back view. Don't just show the front view. Because if we continue showing the back view, our God, as I say, who searches the heart of man,
who searches your heart, who searches your secret life, who searches where you go, what you do after church. He's the same God that knows, and he's the same God that you're accountable. So what am I saying? Be a real Christian. Don't be a Christian who just shows the front view. Be a Christian that when you come, even the back view, the front view, all will see is clean. A heart that is, the heart that is clean before God, not the heart that is clean before man, but before God, it's dirty. See, one day you will stand before God. One day you will stand before God, and you'll be held accountable, not because of what you showed people, but you'll be held accountable by what you did right. In front and back, you'll be held accountable. So I want to encourage you. Maybe you are here, you're saying that, Yvette, I've been going to church, I've been serving God, and when I present myself before people, they see that I'm a Christian, I'm a strong Christian, I'm a prayer warrior, I'm a what? But behind, I'm dealing with some things. Maybe it can be fornication, it can be lies, it can be gossip, it can be any sin, you can be some weakness. But let me tell you, God wants you the way you are. He's ready to clean your back view. As long as that you are able to give him back, he's able to clean your life, clean it more. He's able to clean it out. So I want you to open up your heart and pray with me this prayer. Say, Lord Jesus, come into my heart. Be my Lord and personal Savior. Please forgive me for every sin that I've committed. I've sinned against you, Lord, and I've sinned against this world. Today, have mercy on me. I'm ready for you to take over the front view and the back view of my life and make it clean. I surrender it before you in the name of Jesus. Amen. If you have done that, just know that you have accepted Christ as your Lord and personal Savior, and allow him to work on. Let him work on your hidden agendas, your hidden things, your hidden weakness, and we'll see you through. So God bless you. Make sure, let your front view be the same as the back view. Let not your back view be clean and your front view, your back view dirty and your front view clean. God bless you. In the name of Jesus, I love you. See you next time.